there, fellow travelers. Mark here with Wolters World. Today we're in Granada, Nicaragua, one of the places you really have to check out when you do come here to Nicaragua. And today what we have for you are 10 things that are going to shock you about coming to here in Nicaragua, because there are so many fantastic things here, from the volcanoes to check out. I mean, surfing on volcanoes to the beaches here, to the colonial buildings you'll see in places like Granada and León, that you're just going to be shocked how much you will love it. And the first thing that shocks tourists when they come here is if they take the chicken bus. Yes, the chicken bus is called the chicken bus because you might have chickens in it. It's the local bus you take around the country. You take her through the cities and stuff like that. What's funny about them is they're the old, like, yellow school buses we had in the U.S. growing up, taking us to school. They've been retrofitted to be more of a long-distance bus thing, so there's a little canopy on the insides, and your luggage might go on the top and stuff like that. But it is kind of a really fun experience, and you are shocked when you get on there, when there, yes, there might be chickens on there, or a goat. Like, we were on one of them, they had a huge thing of plantains taking up the entire aisle. So it is kind of a really fun experience when you come here. Now, there's other options out there. You can take the espresso buses, and you can get higher public or private transport. But seriously, you at least gotta take the chicken bus once when you're here, because it is quite the experience, okay? Now, the second shock we have for you goes to the transport, because sometimes you might not take that bus. You might end up in the back of a pickup truck. Yes, reliving the 80s does happen here in Nicaragua if you grew up in the 80s like me, and you will be hitching a ride. Yes, you'll hitch a ride to the beach, or if you're in the rural areas, in the back of a pickup truck, and you'll just be sitting back there, which is kind of a normal thing. But also, you'll see people, three or four people, on a motorcycle. You'll see bikes and motorcycles everywhere here, but on the motorcycles, you'll see mom, dad, and the kid, or mom's on there and two little kids on there. I remember we saw one, this little girl had to be 2 years old, just latched onto mom behind her. It was kind of like, wow. But it was kind of a cool, because, you know, I know that little girl knows how to ride a motorcycle better than I do. Okay, so that's that one. And then the third shock, and then I'll try to get away from the transportation shocks. The third shock people have is the first time someone hops in the taxi with you. Look, when you take a taxi in Nicaragua, it's not your taxi. You're paying for that one seat in the taxi. And so the taxis are kind of a shared thing. So Uber and the shared economy, they've had that stuff in Nicaragua for years, okay? And so when you hop in, there'll be someone else that might hop in as well. So if you want that taxi to yourself, you need to pay the extra on your own to pay for the taxi all alone, okay? Now, the fourth thing that shocks people when they come here to Nicaragua is how cheap Nicaragua is. I'm not saying affordable. I mean, it is really cheap here. You can get a nice hotel, a nice sufficient hotel, for $25 to $35 a night. And I would recommend, if you want to have a little bit nicer, you can pay the extra $5 for a nicer room or a nicer place. But it is really affordable. Going out to eat, $2 for a meal. Okay, go to the market and have a meal there, literally $2. We ate here on the main square. You know, the most overpriced places in all around the world is the main square to eat. We ate here with seven people. Everyone had a big meal and a drink. It was less than $20. I mean, it is crazy cheap coming here. The excursions, the things to do, all kinds of stuff. It really is a really great, cheaper vacation to go to, affordable vacation, which leads into the fifth shock you're gonna have here. Is the reason why it is so cheap is because there's a lot of poverty here. I mean, Nicaragua is one of the poorest countries in the Western Hemisphere. I mean, think about that. One of the poorest places in the Western Hemisphere. And you're coming here, so yes, the things are very, very affordable here for Western travelers. So when you do come here, you will be bargaining for stuff and things like that. But don't be a jerk about the bargaining, because, you know, you may say, well, they're overcharging me by 10 cordobas. I'm like, dude, that's 30 cents. I mean, we've seen guys arguing at markets over literally 30 cents because they wanted the price lower. Yeah, you just gotta think about these things. But really, you will see a lot of poverty. So don't be surprised if you have kids coming to beg or older people begging, things like that. We might give money, or what we do is we'll actually say, hey, look, you want some food? We'll feed the kids, or we'll feed the grandma or grandpa or something like that to help them out. And actually, people have been very appreciative of that. We brought, you know, we've taken gifts to the churches and stuff like that that our church and our schools have donated to leave the churches there to help them distribute it. Because really, I mean, you will see the poverty here. You will see, you know, the shanty, like that shanty that's just shacks all over the place. And you're like, oh my goodness. And yeah, that's the thing is, when you're tourists, don't just take in the beauty of this, but realize there's a lot more stuff out there. And Nicaragua is one of those countries that when you come and you tour here, your money is really helping people. So do make a difference, okay, when you come. Now, the sixth thing that shocks people when they come here is rice and beans. Or would you like beans and rice? Look, you're gonna have a lot of rice and beans when you come here. Gallo pinto, or the painted chicken, or painted rooster, if you will, is rice and beans. I mean, literally, you'll have rice and beans, a gallo pinto for breakfast with scrambled eggs. And then lunch, you'll have rice and beans with chicken. And then for dinner, rice and beans with beef. Look, rice and beans are everywhere here, and you might get a little bored with it, just so you know that. But it is really kind of a staple of it. You'll be like, oh, rice and beans again. What a shock, an ironic shock there. But what's cool is if you're going around, there's actually really good, like the little food carts and stuff like that where people push around. You can get an empanada, you can go there. You can go to a nacatamal, which is tamale they have here with a, it's like in a, they serve it in a banana shell or plantain leaf. Don't eat the plantain leaf. It's got corn flour, meal, tortilla kind of stuff. And inside will be rice or fish and rice and fish or meat or something like that with some spices. Really good. Or here in Granada, you have a casillo, which is a tortilla with cheese and onion and some spice in there. And there's all this really great street food, but it's here, so definitely check that out. But don't be shocked if rice and beans do show up. Even if you ask for no rice and beans, there'll still be rice, and the beans might be separate. So that's one of the things there. Now, the seventh thing that's gonna shock you when you come here are the volcanoes. Look, volcanoes are so prevalent here in Nicaragua, they're actually on the flag, okay? And you'll see, when you go around, you'll see volcanoes, and you can go surfing on volcanoes. Yes, you get a little like mini surfboard, and you surf down some of the volcanoes here. And the thing is, you can go and swim in a volcano crater. You can actually go and see the lava boiling up and other ones. I mean, the volcano stuff you can go to and see here is really amazing. Go to the Ometepe Islands and go see the double volcanoes over there. It's just a really amazing thing to see nature really in force here in Nicaragua. And that's what's so cool about it. It is such a nature kind of driven place. And that's what we really love about it, is all the nature you can do here. And that's why we lead into the shock number eight, is how many cool beaches they have here, but how empty they really are. Because a lot of people are still really scared to come to Nicaragua because they think, oh, Nicaragua, the Sandinistas war and stuff like that. That's a long time ago, okay? Yes, there are still issues here. Since Costa Rica has kind of got too expensive for a lot of tourists, what you have is a lot of people started coming up into Nicaragua. So they'll go surfing in San Juan del Sur, and they'll go see the colonial towns like Granada and Leon and see these things. And it's really starting to develop. But the key thing are those beaches. And you know what? It might be a beach on Lake Nicaragua, or it might be on the Pacific coast where you can go learn how to surf. And the thing is, we've been going to beaches, and one beach has said, oh, that's the really popular beach. It gets really crowded. We went there was like 50 people on the beach. This is not Venice Beach cracked, okay? So just realize that. And the beaches here are stunning. And when you see the sunset on the beaches here on the West Coast or on the, well, the East Coast is really hard to kind of get on stuff. It's kind of impossible to really see anything on the East Coast. So you'll be on the West Coast, seeing that sunset, it is just to die for. Now, the ninth thing that might shock you when you come here is, since I talked about how this is, you know, a pretty poverty-stricken country, is you will have occasional power outages, especially if you're in rural areas. I know when we were out, you know, by San Juan del Sur, you know, out there, we were staying at this like little village area, and during the night, yeah, the power would go out for an hour or so, or sometimes for 5 minutes, or sometimes you'll see your lights flicker and go down. Just realize that power outages probably might happen. You are here, so make sure you do bring up some backup batteries if you are, you know, happy with your cameras and your phones and stuff like that, just in case. I mean, it never lasted very long, but it is something that happens enough that you probably like shocked. Wow, this is happening quite often. Well, yes, it does. And the 10th thing that's going to shock you when you come here is how hot it really can get. I know we're in Central America, it's near the equator, but you really need to know is it can get unbearably hot here during the afternoon hours. We're filming, it's like 8 o'clock in the morning or so, and I'm already starting to sweat. The boys are really hot, and so you do need to be really careful with that. So stay hydrated. Don't drink the tap water here. Get the bottled water, okay? Maybe have a Tonya, a local beer if you want once in a while. It's actually pretty good. But also the SPF, you really need to bring good sun protection when you are here. I mean, look at my face. I've been using 70 SPF on my face and 50 on my body, and I'm still getting burned. So you'll be shocked how strong that sun is down here. So if you're coming from the US or Europe or Northern Europe especially, make sure you bring some really good strong sunblock when you do come here. Anyway, I actually have been shocked how much I've really loved Nicaragua. I mean, I like going to Costa Rica and Mexico, and I figure, oh, Nicaragua, that'll be a nice change. But no, this country is amazing. The people are awesome. The food's been pretty good. I know a lot of rice and beans, but have those little street food stuff. And honestly, the nature here is just amazing. So if you want to learn more about Nicaragua, maybe some don'ts of Nicaragua, some tips on visiting Granada, check us out on our website at waltersworld.com. We're also on Twitter, Facebook, Instagram, and we really appreciate your likes, subscriptions, and we hope you have a great time here in Nicaragua. We know you will, because it is a great surprise place to check out. Adios de Nicaragua.